Welcome to 365 Christian Men, where every day we aim to inspire and encourage with real life stories about men. June 11th, Thomas Hooker. Thomas Hooker lived long before the U.S. had a flag with 13 stars. He was a pastor willing to pick a fight if he believed in the cause. One cause in particular weighed heavy on his heart: the belief that the people had the God-given right to vote. So Thomas took a group of people and founded the colony of Connecticut. Now there's a man ready to act on what he believes. Today's story gives us a closer look at Thomas Hooker, the pastor.
It can be tough, but sometimes the right thing to do is to admit when we're wrong. Thomas Hooker shook his head because he didn't know what to try next. The town troublemaker was at it again. Certainly, like most boys his age, he was young and mischievous. But for this boy, trouble wasn't the exception. It was the norm. And he'd been reprimanded a lot. This time, there was property damage. Seeing his property destroyed, Hooker's neighbor was furious, and he demanded that the boy be reminded that such behavior was wrong. Now Hooker, as the town preacher, was assigned to find out the truth and to dole out the punishment. While Hooker loved the truth, punishing wayward boys was not his favorite task. The boy had been caught and hauled in to see Mr. Hooker, and the child now stood, waiting to be interrogated. In his mind, Thomas Hooker rehearsed the lecture he was about to give, and then he approached the young accused. Some guidance could surely save the boy from destroying property again. Hooker began. Had the boy destroyed the neighbor's property? No. What had compelled him to do such reckless behavior? He didn't do it. Didn't he know he brought dishonor to his family and to God by sinning so much? The boy crossed his arms and again said, "I didn't do it." Hooker scratched his head. The evidence was all there. The property was destroyed. The boy's reputation alone proved it was him. If he'd just tell the truth, his punishment wouldn't have to be as severe. The boy shook his head and said he didn't do it. Hooker asked question after question, but the answers were all the same. The boy said he was innocent this time and that someone else had destroyed the property. By this time, Hooker became angry. Destruction of property was bad enough, but lying on top of it? He'd had enough. His voice rose, and he pointed an accusatory finger. If the boy would just admit the crime, this matter would be done and over with. But the boy sat quietly. "Sir, I see you are passionate. I'll say no more to you." Then he turned, and he ran away. Hooker was left alone, somewhat shocked. What sort of a child would be so rebellious? Soon Hooker realized he'd been very harsh. Aside from knowing the boy's bad reputation, what proof did he really have? No one had witnessed the crime. No one had seen the boy get into trouble with his neighbor. Guilt washed over Hooker as he remembered the look of frustration on the boy's face as he'd run away. What if the boy were innocent? Satan was the accuser and God was the judge. Hooker was the boy's under-shepherd. And though he couldn't figure out the true culprit, God would. And all Hooker could do was find the boy and apologize. Hooker had someone bring the boy back. The child didn't want to meet with the preacher's sad eyes. He wasn't in the mood for another lecture. Hooker told the boy that there was no proof he'd done the destruction. The boy said he hadn't done it. And this time, Hooker believed him. Said he'd wished he'd believed him sooner. Hooker said that when he'd talked before, he'd gotten too angry. "It was my sin. It was my shame," Hooker said. "I am truly sorry for it. And I hope in God I shall be more watchful in the future." The boy's indifferent expression suddenly changed, and he looked confused. He wasn't used to a grown-up apologizing for being wrong. In fact, they'd always said he was wrong. The boy's mouth dropped slightly open, and he didn't know what to say. Hooker continued to provide older, brotherly advice to help the boy stay out of trouble. Psalm 28:13. "He who covers his sins will not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy." Have you wronged someone? Have you judged too quickly? How can you make those things right? It can be tough, but sometimes the right thing to do is to admit when we're wrong.
Thank you for listening to today's story. Every day of the year, our hope is to inspire you with real-life stories of faithful men who have gone before us. Hebrews 12:1 says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." Join us tomorrow for another story at 365christianmen.com.